Welcome to the second half of tonight's ACC doubleheader. The Pitt Panthers are back at home, and they welcome the Wolfpack of NC State to a Steel City shootout next. It's a beautiful but very cold night here in Pittsburgh as we welcome you to the fourth of four ball games on the schedule in the ACC. The Panthers are back at home. Tough loss at Duke on Saturday. They meet NC State, who had a close call but couldn't finish the drill against Miami. With Jason Capel, Wes Durham, welcome to ACC College Hoops. It's been a tough go for the Pitt Panthers. Kevin Stallings' team is winless in seven conference games. Jason, you worry not only about maybe the mental side of it, the validation side of it, all these taxing elements facing his club.
When you look at this Pitt team, it's a team that's young but continues to play extremely hard. And what you want is some validation for that hard work in way of a win. They have to take care of the basketball, and all guys have to come downhill and ensure they can rebound to compete with NC State.
Well, it's interesting with the Wolfpack, because when you talk about NC State, the big fella inside, Omer Yurtseven's been fantastic.
One of the most improved players in college basketball, doing his job inside, but also goes outside and knocks down three-point shots as well. 20 points per game over his last five, and also has put in four double-doubles. An inside force for the Wolfpack.
Well, and Yurtseven and the Wolfpack are trying to get a scratch on the road for the first time in conference play. When we come back, starting lineups, first half action from the Oakland Zoo in the Steel City. The only meeting of the regular season, the Pack and Panthers is next. Well, the Pittsburgh Panthers, 81-54 decision at Duke on Saturday, and of course Sunday, Kevin Keats in his first year, 86-81, was the final in the loss to Miami. It's their best shooting game, however, against the ACC for the Wolfpack, who shot 54% from the floor in the loss. They've won three of their last five. We told you at the top, Pittsburgh's lost seven straight, and Yurtseven breaks the huddle. But Jason, one of the things we'll look at tonight, Omer has had struggles in his three ACC road games.
On the road, and what NC State must do, establish him early, get him some inside touches, but Yurtseven has to do the job on the defensive end, understanding that the Pitt Panthers will try to put him in as many ball screens as possible, pulling him away from the basket.
Let's be honest, he's gone from being a part of the scouting report to being at the top of the scouting report.
To the scouting report. When you average 20 points per game over your last five, you have earned that right. He must do the job of staying out of foul trouble. Such a valuable player this season for the Wolfpack.
Ted Valentine with Tony Green and Kip Kissinger tonight here at the Peterson Event Center. And Pittsburgh goes with their 15th different starting lineup tonight. All five guys have started, but not this particular five. At some point already in the campaign for Kevin Stallings, now in season two here in Oakland. Markel Johnson and the Wolfpack with the opening tap.
Pitt Panthers starting out with a solid man-to-man. The Wolfpack have a size advantage inside.
Soft jumper, Torin Dorn gets NC State on the board.
And on makes, you're going to see the Wolfpack set up in their full court pressure. Coach Keats said he's going to start out man-to-man. Doesn't want to allow Pitt to get out in transition to get easy baskets.
Wilson Frame. Forced error on the Panthers. Cameron Davis and Wilson Frame on the exchange. Neither guy controlled it, and Pittsburgh turns it over.
And those are the unforced turnovers the Panthers cannot have. Averaging 15 per game against the Wolfpack, who's going to pressure for 40 minutes. You must value the basketball.
Dorn again, baseline. Blocked out of there by Parker Stewart, the outstanding freshman for the Panthers. Wilson Frame, a three. And the long rebound for the Pack. State wants to run here, Jason.
NC State wants to play fast. They want to use their defense. Chaotic, force turnovers, but also to generate offense. And in the half court, make no mistake, they're going to get that ball inside. A lack of ball pressure allows the over-the-top pass. Yurtseven does the job putting it in.
4-0 NC State. Omer on the board, the second-best field goal shooter in the ACC at 62%. Marcus Stewart, averaging almost 13 in league play, just under 9 through the course of the regular season. Cameron Davis. Chukwuka. Three ball from out on the right. Kane Chukwuka, sophomore from Sweden, his 8-3 of the year, puts Pitt on the board.
The partner, we saw him warming up before the contest, and he was knocking them down with great consistency. Any offense that the Panthers can get from their front line is an added bonus.
Markell Johnson inside, your 7-1. The foul will be on Chukwuka. It'll be his first and number one on Pitt.
The mandate for the Wolfpack in this contest, get the ball inside. Dirk Seven sets the screen, dives to the opposite block. Great recognition over the top from Johnson. You teach big guys, when you get the ball inside, keep that ball high, power it up. Dirk Seven off to a nice start, that finish. And they're just completing an and one as well.
Yep, 57% free throw shooter, NC State 70% as a team, a little less than that in that neighborhood in conference play. So the Wolfpack with an early 4-point lead, and Carr going to work on the drive. Had it poked away, Beverly tried to save it. Finally controlled in the corner, they'll skip it across, and Parker Stewart launches. Backside rebound allows the Pack to fall into a break. You're at 7, working against Chukwuka. Johnson reroutes along the baseline. Bounce out front, blocked away Davis. Beverly recovers. 12 to shoot. Markell Johnson's line drive three. 12th of the year for the sophomore from Cleveland.
Markell Johnson scoreless the last time out, but put in 14 assists. More than capable of shooting the basketball. And the Pitt Panthers, once again, we talk about if you beat the pressure of NC State, you're gonna get quality looks at the basket. Nice job there from Cameron Davis.
Yep, freshman from Colorado, banged out of bounds. It'll stay to the Pack. Just better than 3 minutes gone, and for both these schools, this game is already a pretty hurried tempo.
Well, set NC State's tempo. That's something, if you're the Pitt Panthers, you have to be aware of. You want to take advantage of opportunities, but you cannot get into a foot race with the Wolfpack.
Johnson, nice pass, with 7, fouled, and that is number 2 on Chukwuka. It'll be his second. And it comes with 16:48 to play, and Kane will likely have to come out of the ballgame.
Wes, what happened there? Chukwuka expected Johnson to take that shot, so he turns his head, trying to box out, which he's outweighed on the front line, trying to keep Dirk Seven off the glass. The ball finds Dirk Seven's hands. You would like for the big fella to finish that. What he's done is taken maybe the best offensive player on the front line of the Pitt Panthers and sent him to the bench with 2 fouls.
So Chukwuka's out, and Terrell Brown has come in. 6'10 freshman from Providence, Rhode Island. As, boy, Omer Yurtseven's off to a fantastic start. He's got 7 of NC State's early points here. 7 of the first 11. Pittsburgh's hit a pair of threes for their only mark so far on the card. Wilson Flame slips it here to Davis. The screen of Brown. Now the reroute. Brown can't knock it down. Saved by Markell Johnson. Seven trying to help with the screen. Here's Al Freeman going to work. Long 2 and tapped out the foul on Rick Seven for going over the back. He's gotten used to doing stuff like this, Jason, but it cost him almost a foul of all game when he tries to keep a ball alive at the offensive end.
Well, the coaching staff told us he gets at least one of those every contest. You don't want to take away the aggression of your big man of attacking the offensive glass. But your 7 has to recognize when he's boxed out, you cannot go over the offensive player's back, the defensive player's back. He's too valuable to this team.
Kevin Keats gets LeVar Batch Jr. on the floor for the first time, and Leonard Freeman. So already 3 Wolfpack subs off the bench here early for State.
and what that brings to the team, instant energy off the bench. He's a dog on the basketball, putting great ball pressure. And Freeman, who's been excellent up front, the issue with getting playing time for him, he and Yurt 7 play the same position.
Al Freeman misses on the drive. Bernard Freeman inside, had it stripped away. And a hustle by Carr, can't save it, into the Panther bench. It'll stay with the Pack. 6:15, 4:15 elapsed in this first half. NC State 12, Pittsburgh 6, as we get a timeout on the floor at the Peterson Event Center. ACC College Hoops from the Steel City continues in a moment. Well, the top of the scouting report doesn't seem to be facing Omeri Yurt 7 tonight.
Doing his work early inside, doing an excellent job running in transition. But what I've been impressed with, always has his eyes on the basketball. Johnson multiple times has gone up looking as if he's going to shoot. Instead, throws it inside to Yurt 7, who has a great awareness of where the pass is coming from. 7 early points, perfect from the foul line in the field. And that's the strength in this ball game for the Wolfpack. Get that ball inside and let the big sophomore go to work.
Hustle play by the freshman Carr came up empty, so the ball inbounded by the Pack as we rejoin you from Pittsburgh tonight. Quick pass inside, Freeman the catch, and he's fouled by Brown. Boy, can't say enough about the early ball movement by NC State in the half-court game as the foul is ticketed to Terrell Brown. And that'll be his first, and that's 3, all on Biggs in the Panther order. Here is Bernard Freeman to the strike. Fifth-year guy has battled injuries to come back, and it was a nice piece for Kevin Keats' first team in Raleigh.
Veteran player on the front line. Battled injury last season with his leg, but now healthy, so strong and physical, and been very consistent at both scoring and rebounding the ball for the Pack.
Shamil Stevenson's come in, a freshman from Ontario, Canada. As you see, Freeman hit both free throws. He's a 71% free throw shooter. And the lead is 8. Here's Stevenson. Back out front, this is Carr. Tend to shoot. We welcome you to Pittsburgh, game 2 of our ACC College Hoops doubleheader. All NC State early, and Al Freeman brings folks watching Georgia Tech and Florida State right live to the baseline there.
That's a perfect example of turning defense into instant offense. The recovery of Torn Dorn and knock it away allows Al Freeman to get in transition, take the harm. The concentration on the rim to take the hit, but also understanding he has an opportunity to complete that three-point play.
Freeman knocks down the free throw. And Malik Abu has come back for State as we are 5 minutes in. The Pack is on a 7-0 run and has built an 11-point lead here already tonight.
And a steady diet of pressure. Each guard for the Wolfpack is going to pick you up 94 feet, pressure the basketball, trying to make you uncomfortable on full 94 feet.
Brown turning with the right hand. Davis tried to clean it up, blocked by Bernard Freeman. Stayed on the run. Bounce past Beverly. And here's Freeman working against Parker Stewart. LeVar Batts Jr.'s 3 is too strong. And a foul will be called inside on Abdul Malik Abu. His first, number 2, on the Pack here in the opening 5.5. Backcourt pressure is really having an effect on Pittsburgh.
Absolutely. LeVar Batts, as I said, when he comes in the game, he's instant energy. A tough guy to screen. He's going to dog you each time you put the ball on the floor. And that sets the tone. He's the head of the snake when he's in the game for the Pack on the defensive side.
Stevenson against Freeman. Hard drive and score. Well done by freshman Shamil Stevenson.
And how do you beat pressure? You attack it. Nice job there from Stevenson, dropping his inside shoulder, attacking left. Got the avenue all the way to the cup.
Pittsburgh into the zone. Started out a couple sequences of man. Beverly a 2 out front. And Stevenson pulled away from Abu. Carr. Nice hesitation into traffic and a kick out for 3, and Davis buries the jumper. His second of the ball game.
Marcus Carr with the hands up action. Now you see me, now you don't. Gets his feet in the lane, draws the defense. Great recognition to find his partner. Free ball quarterback.
Bats, nice pass, high post to Boone. Too strong, Freeman and Stevenson collide. Last touch in the corner by State. It will belong to the Panthers. And about a quick check of Jason Capel's forward keys to the game tonight.
Well, for the Wolfpack, defensive discipline. Pitt is going to make you guard them. You see a lot of slip screens, slipping of ball screens. They Pat must have excellent defensive discipline throughout the contest. And for Pitt, poise under pressure, understanding the Wolfpack is going to pressure you full court. Man to man, run and jump, take care of the basketball, ensuring you have an opportunity to get quality looks on the offensive end.
Here is Johnson off a backcourt turnover by the Panthers, and Markell can't finish the layup. And the rebound for Terrell Brown.
Johnson is telling Dirk 7 that was a lob. He drove to the hoop, drew the defense.
Yep.
Lob for the big fella who, for the first time tonight, was not looking for the pass.
Jonathan Milligan Jr. into the ballgame. First time we've seen probably the most experienced player returning to the roster outside of Ryan Luther, who missed the rest of the year. And Stevenson hits a deep three. His eighth of the year, and all of a sudden, the team averaging 7.5 threes a ballgame has got 4 in the first 7 minutes here tonight.
The Panthers need all hands on deck. The starters as well as guys coming off the bench. And Stevenson giving a lift with instant offense.
Freeman had his shot deflected. Sam Hunt. And with 7 commits the foul, reaching in over the top. Second time he's trying to keep a ball alive on Mary Group 7. Draws his second foul.
The Panthers, great ball movement. The drive to the basket, baseline drive, baseline drift. And Milligan makes the extra pass. Stevenson feet set, hands ready. Steps up and knocks down a timely three-point shot.
Well, Marriott 7 may have to sit on Kevin Keats's bench the final 12-20. That would be a win for Kevin Stallings in Pittsburgh.
That was one of the main things Coach Stallings talked to us about before this contest. Finding a way to get Yurt 7 out of the game. You do that by boxing out each possession and forcing him to go over the back.
Wilson, Frame, and Brown couldn't get linked up on a pass that was there. Had Brown been ready, Jason looked like he would have had an easy bucket, but that's one of the things Pittsburgh's been fighting. The Panthers, 11 scholarship newcomers starting into this campaign for Kevin Stallings.
That's what you have to learn, young player. If you bounce that ball, the big man can locate it, catch it, and then it's an easier opportunity to get to the rim.
Long 3 pounds away. Here is Al Freeman trying to get to the rim. State is now 1 of their last 11 from the floor. And here's Cameron Davis open floor. Bounced it through Stevenson's leg. They'll scramble for it. Davis rolled back over, and a held ball will be called, I believe. And we'll get a timeout. 11:44 to go. State 3-point lead on Pittsburgh. ACC basketball is brought to you by Husqvarna Automore. All-star long, start with Automore. Seeing is believing at automore.us. By Toyota, visit your local Toyota dealer today. Toyota, let's go places. And by Works. Oh, let's roll the videotape. Reynolds Coliseum, December 1st, 1956. The Pack beat Pittsburgh 97-85. Everett Case's team with Nick Pond, one of the valuable front court guys, the late great sportscaster at Channel 5 in Raleigh. But Robert Timmons' Panthers finished with 16 wins that year. I got an unbelievable note about the first game of the series tonight, too. Just so you know. Marcus Stewart, a 3 front rim miss. State has struggled, but has kept the tempo going. And hanging on to the 3-point advantage. Here's Beverly open for a triple. Banged out, Abou, and a foul. Abdul Malik Abou's second. So your 7 has 2, and now Abou 2, 5 total for State.
The Panthers are doing the job each time a shot goes up. A white jersey goes and finds a red jersey, puts a body on him, and simply driving the pack away from the basket. That's one of the keys to this game, taking care of the basketball as well as fighting as a team to rebound.
Here is Milligan, the only Panther on the card tonight that played in the game last year between the two schools. And there's a hand check and a foul. Kip Kissinger tags Braxton Beverly with his first. Six now on NC State. Pittsburgh is a free throw shooting team of just under 70% during the regular season. And right in that neighborhood as well during conference play. First time we've seen Eligoma. He's Eligoma wearing 42 for the Panthers. Out of the corner three, and Wilson Frame. His 37th of the year. Well, Parkberg's knocking threes down tonight.
Partner, we talked about taking care of the basketball and rebounding, but at some point you have to score as well. And the Panthers, 5 for 9 now in the first half. And that zone is taking NC State out of their offensive flow. Tough miss there from Torin Dorn.
Tied at 17 after the three ball by Wilson Frame. And a whistle and foul. Tony Green. And I believe. Let's see who the foul is. Kevin Keats also looking across the way. It's going to be on Braxton Beverly, and it's his second. So State's got three guys with two. Seven total with 10.5 to go, and here's Eligoma at the free throw line. Just 4 of 8 on the year. Young man from Nigeria who at 20 years of age, a raw post prospect though. Jason, there's just no other way to look at it.
But great size, 6'9", 235, a freshman.
Yep.
He's come in, he's screened well, he's boxed out and rebounded. I would say he's doing his job so far in this first half.
Put Pitt in front on the free throws. 19-17. Panthers on a run, and Hunt knocks down the three.
You're going to play zone against NC State. You better find number 15 in red. Sam Hunt. There's a marksman, a specialist. When he comes in the game, he's looking to shoot the basketball at any given time.
Parker Stewart trying to take Hunt on the drive. And the foul on Hunt will be his first. 8 now on State. Free throws coming for the Tennessee freshman, Parker Stewart.
Parker Stewart averaging just under 9 points per game on the season, but 13 points per game in ACC play, including 48% from three. A young man that can shoot it. You see the aggressive drive there. What is that doing? That's allowing the Pitt Panthers to attack downhill, and now in the bonus, an opportunity to put points on the board.
Parker Stewart is our Hardy star to watch. And he knocks both free throws down for his first points at 15 in Saturday's loss at Duke. And now Stallings' team offering a little backcourt pressure here. 1 point lead. Skip into the corner. Freeman with a screen. Markel Johnson. Lob for Freeman. Lamar had it batted away. Recovers. Slips it in traffic. And Dorn traveled with it.
Got to give a lot of credit to the Panther defense. Great communication in the zone. And when the ball gets inside, all 5 white jerseys converging with active hands and bodies. Doing a great job competing here so far.
First turnover of the night on the Wolfpack. Carr. Flips it to Eligoma. Skip out. Wilson Frame, a step back. Wow. Pittsburgh is attacking from behind the arc in the first half.
And their confidence just continues to grow. You attack pressure, unselfish play, making the extra pass. This is a young team that is gaining confidence throughout this contest.
They have 1 2-point field goal in this first half.
Well, it's because they're attacking the pressure, getting their footprints in the paint. You see each guy has his head up, being very unselfish, moving the basketball, passing up what could be a good shot for great shots, and individually guys are stepping up, making plays, knocking down shots from distance.
The latest is this left side three by Wilson Frame. He's got 6. Cameron Davis has 2 threes. 1 for Stevenson and 1 for Chukwuka before he left with 2 fouls. And what was thought to be early trouble for Pittsburgh, they've been bailed out by their 3-point shooting and NC State's drought. Al Freeman can't hit the open baseline jumper.
There's something about seeing the ball go through the hoop that gives you more energy. Now you see defensively, guys are talking, feeling confident. This is a very connected team right now here on their home court.
Ellie Goldman touched it over the end line. It will belong to the Wolfpack. With that, Cameron Davis, who we just spoke of a moment ago, returns to the order for Pittsburgh. Kevin Stallings, 57-year-old native of Collinsville, Illinois, played in a Final Four with Purdue in 1980 at Market Square Arena in Indianapolis. Sam Hunt, got it.
West, he's a shooter. If he catches it and he can see the orange circle on the backboard, his job is to let it fly. You have to have recognition in a zone of where Sam Hunt is at all times.
Stay to within one. Carr, Wilson Frame, give it another whirl. 9 for Jared Wilson Frame.
Now conversely on the other side, 0 and White. He's hot. Only 27% from distance on the season, but he's shooting a hot basketball here so far, and his teammates are doing an excellent job finding him in rhythm.
Now Freeman tries to answer. Bounces off the iron. Lenard Freeman kicked it around. Finally, Carr away with it. Attacking off the drive and blocked by Markel Johnson. They'll score the basket for Marcus Carr. First basket for the freshman Carr from Toronto. Boy, what an athletic play by Markel Johnson.
A great job from Carr attacking downhill. Markel Johnson coming out of nowhere. That looked like a clean block to me, partner. I thought he took it to the backboard.
6-point lead for Pittsburgh. Under 8 to play. Lenard Freeman, one dribble up strong. And the backside followed by Dorn, no good.
Freeman has to finish that play.
Yep.
Did his work early, 2 feet in the paint. You got to go up strong and finish inside.
That's 7.5 minutes. Only the 2 Sam Hunt triples accounting for NC State's marks. Huddle foul again. Dorn battling, but the rebound pulled away by Davis. Pittsburgh playing with a lot of bounce now, and Wilson Frame inside draws the foul. That's going to get us to a timeout. 7:25 to go first half. Jared Wilson Frame, part of the 3-point barrage here in the first half for the Panthers, who lead by 6 at home. ACC basketball is brought to you by Spirit Communications, our fiber, our network, your business. Six-point lead for Pittsburgh. NC State started 4 of 6. They're 3 of 20 since, but we'll give Kevin Stallings' team credit, Jason. When they played the opening, what, almost 13 minutes? You never know they were hitting this in 7 ACC games.
Coach Stallings has his team prepared to come out and compete. When you make shots, you have attention to detail on the defensive end. You're giving yourself a chance to compete on a nightly basis here in the ACC. And at home, this team's playing in attack mode, shooting at a big basket. You look at Wilson Frank, a young man who over his last 4 games was 2 for 20 from the 3-point line, already 3 for 5 here tonight.
By the way, is now 19 of 19 at the free throw line in ACC play. Lead is 8 for the Panthers. Beverly in the corner from Hunt. Al Freeman's 3 rattled out. And a rebound for Parker Stewart. And Wilson Frame. Exchange with the freshman Brown. I've been impressed with Marcus Carr, who's got it out here on the perimeter.
He's handled the pressure, dribbling with his head up, always looking to make the right pass. A tough entry there from Stewart. High ball turnovers allows NC State to get out in transition.
Dorn had it scraped away from behind by Brad. Carr the other way, tees up Parker Stewart. And Lenard Freeman pulls down the rebound. Beverly and NC State the other way. Sam Hunt trying to get inside the line. And it got stripped away by Carr. It'll stay with the Wolfpack. Pittsburgh with an 8-point lead here. Here comes LeVar Matt for Hunt. The Wolfpack order.
This zone of the Pitt Panthers has really slowed down the Wolfpack. They're packing it in, forcing the Wolfpack to take contested outside jump shots, not allowing any driving lines and any touch inside to a big. You see white jerseys converge immediately.
Here's Beverly waiting on a Freeman screen. Inside Thorne, strong to the basket. Brown altered that, last touch by Pitt. 10 to shoot for NC State. Pittsburgh with their largest lead so far in their first eight ACC games. Fast, six to shoot, Beverly. Got it. Out of the corner, Braxton Beverly's 32nd three of the year is his first point tonight.
You love the recognition from Bax. He drove the ball hard to the middle, spun back, understanding that Beverly would be sprinting to the weak side corner. Nice recognition.
Brown the dunk. Wilson Frame has been really good in the first half.
Well, when you knock the hell three-point shots, the defense has to pressure up. That allows the others, that time Brown, to roll to the hoop unimpeded. Nice find and finish.
7-point lead. Approaching 5.5 to go. Beverly, another one. Dorn up top to get the rebound. Back strong, can't finish. Terrell Brown pulls it away. Carr, Wilson Frame, all the way to the end.
West, move number one in transition. You must stop the basketball. Wilson Frame, a right-hand player that loves to go right, gets all the way to the cup for an uncontested finish.
And down 9, Omer Yurtseven comes back for NC State as Jared Wilson Frame has already got 13 in this first half. Comes in averaging 12-1, leading Pittsburgh in scoring.
Wilson Frame doing the job there in the ball screen. You see Lenard Freeman sticks with it too long. Beverly doesn't rotate. Brown slices right to the rim for an easy dunk inside.
Al Freeman working through traffic, wide open, missed a shot. Stevenson.
Recipe keeps his dribble and has recognition of where he is. He can get all the way to the rim for a layup.
Perimeter foul on the Wolfpack, and it's on the freshman bounce on Concord. Number one player in the Tar Heel State a year ago, 19 foul on the Pack. Pittsburgh will shoot free throws with 4:51 to play. And it's Marcus Carr from Toronto. His brother, Dwayne Notice, played for Frank Martin on that Final Four team a year ago. And it rattles out for Carr, who's 89% on the year. Jason, just his seventh miss in 55 free throws.
What you're seeing, this young Pitt Panther team gain confidence here at home. I thought they struggled early against the pressure of the Wolfpack, but now settled in. They've seen the ball go through the hoop. And Marcus Carr in the point guard position has really set the table for the rest of the team.
That State answer here. This is a pretty big 4.5 for him, isn't it?
Well, 14 is back in the game. Get the ball inside, allow him to go to work. But that's exactly what the Pack does. When he was in the game, the Pack started dominating.
9 for Yurtseven now. 4.5 to play. The lead is 8 for Pittsburgh. Your 7 plays with the 2 fouls, remember. On the drive, Shamel Stevenson. He has 7.
Stevenson has been like Benny the Microwave Johnson. Instant offense off the bench.
Yeah.
In a variety of ways. Knocked down a 3. He's seen the drives. Excellent job being prepared when your number is called to step in and produce.
There goes Freeman on the drive and a hand check foul on Davis. That'll be his first, freshman from just outside Denver. 15 foul on Pittsburgh. Kevin Stallings' team never led by more than 5 in any ACC game. They've been into double figures with the advantage so far here in this first half. Milligan has come back in, by the way, to spell Carr. Wearing number 2 for the Panthers. Al Freeman from the corner. Brown the rebound.
Those are shots you have to make if you're NC State.
Is it Pitt's advantage, Jason, to slow it here in the last 3 minutes or so?
Well, I think they're in a good rhythm right now. They're doing the job defensively, forcing tough outside shots. Even the ones that are open, you're in NC State's head now.
Tough shot by Brown.
You have to ensure the right guys are getting the looks. You can't allow this last 3:25 NC State to make a push heading into halftime.
Johnson tried to get it to Green 7, threw it just behind his reach. Texas still breaking the action. Jamel Stevenson and the Panthers. Double figure advantage as we go down the stretch in half one. ACC College Hoops on a Wednesday night in Steel City. Don't forget ACC All Access. Starts this week on your regional sports network. Long visit with UVA senior redshirt Devin Hall. That's a preview of all the big matchups coming up this weekend. Check your local listings on your regional sports network. Hall is really one of the more underrated stories of this campaign, Jason. Tony Bennett's captain.
Does a bit of everything. Has shown the ability to make shots. Excellent slasher and facilitator. And does the job as all of the Cavaliers do. And sitting down, spreading out, and defending for full 40 minutes. One of the great leaders we have in the ACC this season.
Virginia 19-1, 8-0 in the league. Is at number 4 Duke on Saturday. Blue Devils went to 6-2 in the league, 18-2 overall with the win at Winston-Salem last night against Wake Forest. Interesting 3 minutes now. Pittsburgh went 12-44 without committing a foul. And here in that town, going on a 32-11 run. Break Terrell Brown, the dunk.
The Panthers picking apart the Wolfpack defense. Now you see the ball screen action bringing York 7 away from the basket. If the rotation is not on time, it's going to lead to easy opportunities for the simple fact that Wilson Frame is not down 3-point shots. He attacks. You see there, Dotson is in no man's land. He's not covering the hole, seeking to run back out. To Johnson on the perimeter as a shooter. He has to cover the hole first and protect the basket.
Terrell Brown picked up the foul, his second. 6 on the Panthers. So Adegoma has come back to the ball game. We're at 42 for the host team. Foul line for Freeman. Back for Hunt, left open. Back rim miss. And the rebound for Wilson Frame. Pittsburgh dodged one there. Off a hand to Greensboro, North Carolina, Sam Hunt.
I like the fact that Wolfpack put a guard there at the ACC area. But Al Freeman on the catch has to turn and look at the hoop. He must be a threat from that position, not just a facilitator.
In the corner, 3 ball from Davis is good. And 3 threes for Cameron Davis in the first half. Pittsburgh is on fire from behind the arc. That's down 8 of 15 from behind the arc.
And everyone is getting in on the action. Unselfish play. Once again, taking advantage of the ball screens. A nice roll and replace action. And each guy has their hands and feet ready to catch and let it fly.
How about tonight's Toyota Let's Go Places? One of the all-time great gentlemen in our business is Dick Groats. An accomplished baseball player. 1960 MVP. Played mainly for the Pirates, also spent some time with the Cardinals. You know what? His jersey number 10 was the first ever retired by Duke. 1952 National Player of the Year, 2-time All-America, and the only player in NCAA history to lead the country in scoring and assists. Now, he told me tonight, there's his partner, the voice of the Steelers, longtime voice of the Panthers, Bill Hooker. Dick Groats told me, as a freshman at Duke, he saw the first Pitt State game because they played it at Cameron Indoor Stadium in 1948. And why did they play it at Cameron? It was State's homecoming game, and they didn't have a facility for it. 3 ball away by Beverly, recovered by the Panthers. Groats, I said, why'd you go? He said, I was homesick. I knew a bunch of guys that played for Pitt. How about that?
Playing on an opposition's home floor, something that I don't think we'll see again anytime soon in modern-day college athletics.
I think everybody's got a spot.
Absolutely.
Like they all kind of know where they want to go.
Absolutely.
8 to shoot. Milligan, baseline. Beverly knocked it away. Freeman recovered. Hunt. Nice job by Davis to find Sam Hunt in the transition. Walked away from him, and boy, Markel Johnson almost had a sensational foul there. coming up on the final minute. It's been all Pittsburgh now after the early run by the Panthers. Milligan had it picked away, and that's Hunt.
You could see that turnover coming a mile away. And Coach Stallings immediately turns to the bench, yells for Paul to come back to the ball game to finish. And NC State getting the ball inside. Yurtseven is perfect on the night. If he gets 2 feet in the paint, you're not going to stop him. Takes the contact and a big time lefty finish inside.
Oh, Hillgrove and Grove. They've been almost 40 years together. I'm going to tell you what, the stuff on here has got to be about a third of how good the stuff is off there. Those guys are awesome. It's always great to visit with them. 11 first half points for Yurtseven, who's been handcuffed now by the fouls. And he's still going to go to the locker room. Far and away, the Wolfpack's leading scorer, Jason.
The game changed when he went to the bench. He has been perfect. A guy that scored inside, taking contact and finishing, stepped to the line and consistently knocked down foul shots. This game changed when he got that second foul and the Pitt Panthers took over control and got into an excellent rhythm on both sides of the ball.
Well, Panthers with a 12-point lead. Davis brings it front court. Markel Johnson almost knocked it away and then did. And here is Johnson, open floor, and he'll stuff it home.
Johnson got the mandate. He had 14 assists his last time out, but Coach Keats was not happy about his play defensively. Active hands on the ball, knocks it away. Live ball turnovers are going to lead directly to points in transition. And if you're Pittsburgh, you cannot allow the Wolfpack to get into a rhythm and finish this half on a strong note. You must take care of the basketball if you're Marcus Carr.
All right, now we're going to deal with two different worlds here. Kevin Stallings is going to play from in front here in a locker room with a team that has not quit. They have competed. It just hasn't gone well. So the things we talked about at the top, the validation, the mentality you got to have. What's he going to tell this group?
Did a great job in the first half. We moved the ball. We were very unselfish. We got here because of our defense. We boxed out. We were active defensively. That's what allowed us to get confident shooting the basketball. Yeah. But it's only 20 minutes. We played the first half simply to get to the second half. There's 20 more big minutes to play. Make no mistake, the Panthers must finish this half strong. They're the Wolfpack. Active hands, knocking that ball away. And with 22 ticks to go, have another possession to carve into this lead.
Al Freeman, after the forced turnover in the backcourt. Here is Bass. State can hold for the final shot here in the opening corner. And Johnson and the pack will do just that. Markel for Freeman. Lost the handle on it. Here's Hunt. Resets with three. Launches. Front rim miss. Freeman put it back up. Horn sounds. Pittsburgh will go to the locker room. And the lead is 10. So the Panthers built an early advantage. Lead by 10 at the break, despite a 5-0 run by State in the final 37 seconds. Hardy's halftime report from Pittsburgh coming up next. ACC basketball is brought to you by Hardee's, home of the $5 All-Star Meal. Welcome back to the Hardee's Halftime Report in Pittsburgh tonight, where the Panthers lead North Carolina State 43-33 at the break. And with Jason Kapor-Western, welcome back to our coverage. Hope you enjoyed Georgia Tech, Florida State, Tallahassee in game one of our doubleheader. This has been very entertaining. Pittsburgh is living on the three, though, Jason, in the opening 20 minutes, and a lot of it from Jared Wilson-Frank.
Well, they've done a great job competing in the first half, turned the ball over, but really settled in. The zone defense gave them a lot of good looks. And offensively, you talk about it, partner, playing inside out, getting it inside, and then filling it up from three. Wilson-Frank knocked down one, then got comfortable, able to get in transition all the way to the hoop. But he's made his living scoring, facilitating. And when you make shots, it causes the defense to rotate. That allows the others, as Brown inside, to roll to the hoop for easy baskets.
He's got 13, of course, to lead the Panthers. 12 for home here at 7, as NC State is to within 10. Here at 7 spent some time on the bench in the first half with fouls. We'll come back with more in a moment. Hardy's halftime report continues here from Pittsburgh. At the break, the Panthers lead NC State by a score of 43-33. And a quick check of the ACC standings. Virginia at the top at 8-0. And I guess, Jason, the thing that catches your eye is only five games separate 1-13 as we get to the midway point of the conference schedule coming up this weekend.
Well, you look right now and so much parity in league play. Louisville in overtime right now in a big game on the road against Miami. The Blue Devils beginning to play on the defensive end to complement their high-octane offense. But the Virginia Cavaliers, the job they do defensively, and now with Guy as well as Jerome knocking down shots from the perimeter, they are clearly the team to beat in the ACC.
Cavaliers are in Durham, of course, on Saturday. It's a big weekend of ACC basketball. We think next Wednesday night will be a lot of fun. Doubleheader of ACC action. These Pittsburgh Panthers will be in South Florida to beat Miami. Then at 9 o'clock, the J. Rob and Bo Show at home at the Conti Forum against Virginia Tech. Check your local listings for the doubleheader Wednesday in the ACC on your regional sports network. 10-point lead for Pittsburgh. Beautiful Wednesday night in the Steel City. Hardy's halftime report continues in a moment. Pittsburgh 43, NC State 33. The Panthers, 8 of their 14 field goals were threes. NC State under 26% from the floor. Second half next. Thanks for watching the Hardy's Halftime Report. ACC basketball is brought to you by the official corporate champions of the Atlantic Coast Conference, GEICO, New York Life, Bojangles, Food Line, and by Toyota. We're getting ready to go to the second half and a quick check on the Permane Brothers sandwich. You want to tell everybody how good that was tonight?
Well, I got to give my partner an assist for telling me about it and taking me to lunch. Big time sandwich, and the Pitt Panthers doing the job, putting their sandwich together here.
Oh,
giving the ball, but also putting NC State into pick and rolls, bringing the bigs away from the hoop, feeding inside, and then replacing with shooters on the perimeter. The Pitt Panthers surgical in the first half of the offensive end, led by that man right there, Jarrett Wilson-Frame.
Remember now, 8 of the 14 field goals were threes. Sometimes that ratio is great. You got to be able to stay with it a little bit, don't you? And how about a move? Strong to the iron to start half two.
Exactly the way the pack began the game. Force feeding that ball inside there. Yurtseven, who was perfect in the first half, delivering to Abu, who goes up high for the finish.
Here's Wilson-Frame. Jason told you his dynamics. He'll take your 7 to the basket, and there's number 3 on O'Meara Yurtseven. His first. His third and the first on State here in the half. And this is what we were telling you. 8 of the 14 field goals were threes. NC State, 4 threes, but more, I guess, was the 25%, 26% shooting in the first half.
And also the Pitt Panthers plus 4 on the backboard.
Right.
The 8 turnovers, many of those were early in the contest. So taking care of the ball, ensuring you get good looks, and then battling on the backboard. And now Yurtseven already picking up foul number 3. This game changed in the first half when he was saddled with those two and had to go to the bench.
21 straight free throws in ACC play for Jarrett Wilson-Frame. Back to a 10-point game. Dorn, bounce pass, Rick 7 the catch and score. Soft touch for the big fella. He's got 14 on his 5th field goal.
It's a different ball game when Yurt 7 is in. Nice job from Dorn, delivering that ball with the bounce pass, allows the big fella to locate it. Those are pots for soft touch.
Davis Wilson Frame thinking about it. Against the boo. Crossed over, scooped and scored. 17 for Wilson Frame.
Wilson Frame is in his bag this evening. He's doing a bit of everything on the offensive end, making others better, but he is scoring the basketball at a high clip from all three levels.
Here's Rip 7 to catch, and trying to get Dorn on the back cut. Overshot him, turned over by the Wolfpack.
You see the shot fake. Attacking the bigger defender. Great body control, the Euro step. And when you knock down three-point shots in the first half, the defense is gonna push up a little more. Great recognition by Wilson Frame. Coach Peace imploring his team to pick up the pressure, force some turnovers to allow the Pack to get out in transition.
Chibuka. Wilson Frame missing with the three, the rebound from Johnson. Markell fires ahead, a boo to catch. Can't finish. Recovers inside and scores. Abdul Malik Abu, the 240-pound senior from Boston, has got a pair of field goals that are already in half two.
And Wes, they need him to play better. He has to produce. He's a guy with great ability and excellent athlete. They need him to step up and make plays here in the second half.
The book of the miss. Carr, Wilson Frame, second chance opportunity. Parker Stewart left alone. State to within eight with the ball. Beverly, Yurt 7, nice pass. Dorn can't finish. Abu drives on the backside and draws the foul.
How many of those point-blank shots did the Pack miss in the first half and now is carried over? On the road against a team that has gained confidence, must finish those easy plays right now.
Foul is on Kade Chibuka. It's his third. It's the first on Pittsburgh here in half number two. And Abdul Malik Abu, 56% of the year. On the line, knocks down the free throw. He has five. In the last four games, 11-minute average, about 3 points and a rebound and a half. But Abu's got six all here in the second half. And then playing at the front of the press here, too.
He's a respected player at the ACC. Has battled injuries this season. Right? And he's a guy that you expected to be a double-double machine this year. He has to step up and produce. The Pack needs him and his inside presence here on the road to win this game.
Davis tried to go across. Wilson Frame almost had it picked by Dorn. Now a skip for Carr in the three. Short. And the rebound pulled away by Dorn. You get the sense that NC State is playing with a little more composure here in the early stages of half two.
And it's beginning with their defense.
Beverly a triple. And rimmed out for it. You're saying it starts at the defensive end?
Well, defensively, they're connected. Not allowing easy drives to the hoop for that ball to get downhill. And that's where the game starts for the Wolfpack. On the defensive end of the floor.
Wilson Frame loops it in over the top of your 7. 19 now for Jared Wilson Frame. His career high. High post, Rick 7 had it picked away by Stewart. Turned over by State. Carr. Wilson Frame working through. Remember, you're at 7 playing with the fouls. Can't aggressively pursue it defensively. And then Dorn couldn't catch it before it went over the inline and stay with the Panthers. Almost 4 minutes into the second half. Here's Sam Hunt for a boo. The NC State order. Stevenson is in for Chibuka. Terrell Brown has also reported back. Parker Stewart sits down. Well, both coaches wasting no time exchanging personnel. Almost 4 minutes gone, second half. Wilson Frame back with the up and under. A career high for him. As he gets his 7th field goal, his 21st point.
That's his big boy's move inside. Wilson Frame, the big frame. Johnson on his back. We call that small fry. And he takes full advantage, takes the horn, puts it in the rim.
And a little flex at the end for emphasis. Transfer from Northwest Florida State Junior College in Hartford, Connecticut. He played his high school ball. He's carrying the Panthers here in half two, 4 minutes in. 11-point lead again for Kevin Stallings' club, looking for their first win in ACC play here in game eight. Knocked away on an entry pass. Stevenson, 3-on-2. Big fella tried to get to the rim. Offensive foul. The freshman from Toronto, his first, second on Pittsburgh. And a timeout. Here at the Peterson Event Center. Braxton Beverly took the brunt of the blow. Back after this. Senior from Boston, Abdul Malik Abu, but he's helped NC State with 6 second half points already, Jason.
And high percentage looks at basket, doing his job inside, running in transition, unable to finish, but sticks with it. Strength and power, allowing Abu to get that ball to the cup, and they need his production. Rebounding, scoring inside, but also just being a physical presence there on the front line.
State trails 11. Hunt, Freeman, Beverly, and you're at 7 on the floor. Lemire, you're at 7, is perfect tonight. The rest of the team is 9 of 44. Hunt fires off the corner. Slapped up in the air. Davis can't come up with it. It will stay with NC State.
Anyone inside to contest your set.
5 minutes gone here in the second half. Still a 9-point lead for Pittsburgh. Marcus Carr trying to get to the rim. Shot fake and score. Your seven cannot be as aggressive, Jason, with the foul trouble.
But a big time play by the freshman. Coming to a jump stop, showing the ball. Gets your seven in the air and then gathering himself, Carr, going up for a nice floater.
Beverly. Dribble and Hunt. Post area, Yurt 7 to catch. Hunt flags it down, 7 to shoot. Markel Johnson. Kicks for Beverly, 3, and it is short. Hit the rim, and out of bounds. Last touch by NC State. Wasted opportunity. Kevin Keats wants his team to be a little more clock conscious, I think.
Well, when you're playing against a zone, you can't simply go east and west. At some point, you have to attack downhill, put the zone in rotation, then make the correct basketball play. The Wolfpack has to attack smarter on the offensive end.
Ball got knocked out of bounds. It'll stay with Pittsburgh. Our match junior in the ball game, Kevin Stallings, trying to get his group set for the underneath out of bounds play. Brown out front. Here's Carr. Long three. Pass the rebound. Carr back to that high dribble.
But Pitt does the job getting back in transition. Another way to beat a zone is to beat it down the floor. But the Panthers doing a nice job getting back stuff, and then falling right back into that 2-3 zone. But making the extra pass, Sam Hunt finds it. Al Freeman in the corner. The Pack, they're getting good looks. At some point, they must begin to knock it back.
6 for Freeman, the lead cut to 8 for the Panthers. Wilson Frame having a career night. Davis picked up on the dribble briefly. Now to Carr. Tend to shoot. Marcus Carr trying to get by Beverly. For the bucket, but does draw the foul from the freshman. Kentucky, third on Beverly, third on State. And look out, here comes Marcus Carr in the living room.
Facing a short shot clock, Marcus Carr looking like a running back hitting the hole. drops that inside shoulder, gets downhill, does a nice job recognizing the shot clock, then attacking the rim. And Coach Keats turns his head, walks down the sideline. His team did a pretty good job there defensively for 23 seconds, but you must do the job and defend without fouling.
Carr and Eligomo were part of that Montverde Academy team, Jason. Carr, though, had a knee injury as a senior. So, really, he was kind of forgotten in the recruiting process a little bit. Tell you what, if you can get through the growing pains as a freshman, this guy could be a pretty good player in the league, I would think.
He's showing me a lot so far. Great composure and poise. The point guard position, the toughest in the ACC to come in and compete and lead your team. But he's doing the job here tonight.
10-point lead for Pittsburgh, who's only been over 60 once in ACC play. Beverly launching. With seven kept alive. LeVar fast in traffic. Blocked away by Brown. It will stay with State.
And West, the zone is winning if you continue simply to shoot three-point shots. There are gaps in the zone that you can force the defense to get in rotation and create opportunities at that ACC area and in the short corners.
Freeman kicks it out. Sam Hunt ripped off with seven. A great play. Now Freeman and a new shot clock for State. Freeman on the drive, took the contact, with seven, and a foul. And the foul is going to be called on Terrell Brown.
Well, a late whistle, and Coach Stallings does not like it. But that's exactly what I'm talking about. The Wolfpack, you can't continue to simply tee it up from distance. At some point, you have to attack those gaps in the zone and get down here. You get opportunities to dump it off for teammates, or you can earn your way at the line, stop the clock, and put points on the board. And that's what you have to do trying to mount a comeback.
Seven for Alaric Freeman, the grad transfer from Baylor. Went to Olympic High School in Charlotte and finished out in Nevada at Finley Prep. He's got now 5.5, 8 in the ballgame, and NC State's got 18 second chance points tonight. And here's some backcourt pressure on Milligan with Beverly defending. In the ball game. Parker Stewart made two free throws tonight. Missed Batten with the field goal there, but 15 to shoot. 8 minutes gone in the second half. 8-point lead for Pittsburgh. Back door. Eligomo attacks it later. First field goal for the big fella from Nigeria.
Wilson Crane is doing everything for this ball club. His fingerprints are on everything positive happening for the Pitt Panthers, whether scoring, leading the charge defensively, or being a great facilitator throughout this contest.
Trying to bounce in the corner, ball got kicked by Stevenson. We get a timeout. 11:32 to go on Wednesday night in Pittsburgh. Late night in the ACC. The Panthers lead is 10. ACC All Access this week on your regional sports network, including our sit-down visit with UVA senior guard Devin Hall. Also look ahead to a busy weekend of ACC basketball. Check your local listings on your regional sports network. With Jason Capel, Wes Durham, our producer Dave Barringer, our director Brent Lancaster tonight here at the Peterson Event Center. A turnover by NC State is just their seventh of the ball game tonight. Pittsburgh is still shooting 50% for the ball game. They have cooled off, though, from behind the line. They hit 8 threes in the first half. They have yet to hit one in 5 tries in the second half. The State still trails by 10. Al Freeman. Bats. Cuts through. Leonard Freeman lost it over the inline. Second straight possession. Ends in a turnover for Kevin Keats' club.
Out of a timeout, you turn the ball over, and there, Bats had an angle on the catch in the corner simply to drop it down the baseline for Freeman, who was battling inside.
What a play by Bats, and then he lost it, tried to go back inside, so State gives it right back again. Created a turnover, and then had one of their own. Ellie Goma. Milligan firing away. And the long rebound for Stevenson. He was able to easily control it against Bass. And then blocked out of there, Freeman. And last touch by Sam Hunt. It'll stay with Pittsburgh. Sloppy at both ends, but good defensive efforts.
Both sides, but Stevenson doing a nice job with the offensive rebound. And you must be aware of the weak side coming over. Nice block up high from Freeman. Coach Keats sending in his starters, Torn Dorn and Amir Yurtseven, back in this ballgame.
Inside, Yurtseven bothered that one, kept it alive after the Parker Stewart miss.
There's no reason for guards to try to overpower and get the ball inside. That allows NC State, that block is a tunnel. That allows NC State to get out in transition, where now they're not playing against a set defense. Sam Hunt, always ready to knock it down from three.
Shooter shoot, Hunt has got three threes now tonight for his 9 points. Stevenson on the drive, and Dorn will be called for the foul. Second on Torin Dorn Jr. and the fourth on the pass.
Wolfpack wants to attack early. Nice block there from Omir. The Pack getting out in transition. You see Johnson with his head up. And Sam Hunt in transition finds his feet, locks in. But the Pack must do a better job in the half court defending without fouling. In the first half, put the Panthers on the line in the bonus. About 8 minutes to go in the half.
Pittsburgh is perfect at the foul line here in the second half. They're now 6 for 6, and that's the first free throw of the night for the freshman Stevenson. He's had two double-figure games against the ACC, and he's got 9 tonight. Pitt is 60 points for the second time in an ACC game. Zone again by the Panthers. Been very good to them tonight, Jason. Yurtseven trying to help with a screen for Johnson. Sam Hunt, backside miss. Dorn had a shot at it, poked out of there by Davis. It'll stay with the Pack.
In the zone that possession, Yurtseven was the guy in the ACC area. I would love for that to be Torin Dorn, where he can catch face, pass opposite, attack downhill, or throw it up high for Yurtseven to simply catch and finish.
9.5 to play. Beverly. Dorn. Now here's Yurtseven to catch. Left it short with the left hand. He gets his first miss of the night for the floor. And it is. 7 tries. 9-10 to play. Stevenson shook Dorn. In traffic scores on the drive. Shamil Stevenson. He has 11. And Pittsburgh's lead is 11.
He shook Torin Dorn out of his sneakers there with that possession. Nice job from Stevenson being in attack mode throughout this contest.
Beverly. State's having a hard time finding the seam, Jason. Lob, Dorn, dunk.
We talk about the short corners in the ACC area being the sweet spots against the zone. But you have to look up and attack downhill. You can't play side to side. You must attack gaps and force that zone to move.
State puts the press on, down 9 again. Haven't been able to draw much closer than that, though. Blocked hard by Yurtseven. Here's Dorn leading the break. Tries to find the lane. Ellie Goma there. Torin Dorn with the left hand. 1-on-4. Torin Dorn continues to attack. And what a tough finish. Switch it to the left hand. 7-point game, under 8 to play. Stewart in the corner for Carr's 3. Hunt the backside rebound. Lob ahead, Dorn blocked away and it'll score the bucket. Ellie Goma touched it around the cylinder. 6.5 for Dorn and 8 in the game. NC State to within 5 as we go. Under 8 to play tonight in Pittsburgh. Trying to scratch in the ACC win column for the first time this year. Well, under 8 to go. We welcome you back to Pittsburgh with Jason Cable, Wester on the Pack on a 6-0 run to get to within 5 here, Cable.
They're attacking downhill, getting out transition, and that's how you defeat a zone. You do the job defensively, you're able to get transition to where now you're playing against a broken court. Sam Hunt from the trail, 3-point shots, going on his own private run, a 5-point jam and attacking 1-on-4 with the lucky lefty finish. And each make allows the Wolfpack now to set up their press and try to force another turnover from the Big Panthers.
State brings all five defenders to the midcourt line and into the backcourt now. Carr with Stevenson, Davis. By the way, Chukwuka has come into the ballgame along with Jared Wilson-Frame, who's on a career night with 22 points. Pittsburgh, who had 8 threes in the first half, yet to find one here in the second half. Frame tries to change that, cannot. You're at 7, another rebound. He's got 16 to lead State. The Pack to within 5. Johnson wants a screen. Out front, Hunt. 10 to shoot. O'Meara calling for it. Sam Hunt into the corner. Dorn fires.
West, the ball never attacked downhill. It never touched the center area. The zone is going to defeat you if you do not do one of those two things each possession.
Under 7 to go. Call. Wilson Frame again. Trying to attack with the dribble. Here's Davis. Slashing in. Chukwuka to catch and score. Kanae's second field goal. He has 5. The lead goes back to 7.
Each time the Pack makes a run, this young Pitt Panthers team does the job of making the next play. Beverly shot that one from the Pitt logo. A tough shot. Every possession now with 6 minutes to go means so much. You must value your offensive possessions at your NC State.
6 minutes to play. Wilson Frame on the drive. Beats Chukwuka, who scores, and it falls over the top of Beverly. Third field goal, second in a row for the sophomore from Sweden, who transferred from New Mexico Junior College into Kevin Stallings' program. Hunt tries to answer. Spun out, Dorn the rebound, and then he's fouled on the stick back. And it's on Marcus Carr.
Been really impressed here in the second half with Wilson Frame facilitating. He gives it up, gets it back, and then attacks and puts the defense in rotation. That creates an open avenue for Chukwuka to simply catch, going strong, and finish.
Free throw by Dorn. Jason gives him 9. Here comes Parker Stewart for Stevenson. So the young freshman from Union City, Tennessee, back on the floor. He's got 2 free throws tonight. As Torin Dorn Jr., ACC legacy. His brother Miles is a safety at North Carolina in football. His dad, Torin Dorn, a former Tar Heel tailback. They'll have to work on that come Saturday at noon in Chapel Hill. When Carolina and State play for the first time this year. Carr in the backcourt. Skip across here for Davis. We're getting to a point, though, Jason, inside 5.5 now, where Kevin Stallings has probably got to start about thinking about how's this team going to get this to the house where they haven't been this year, right?
How are they going to finish this game and execute on both ends? And to do that, you must take care of the basketball, get quality shots, and your defense has to stand up, do the job as they've done throughout, and finish possession with rebounds.
Fast call for the travel, trying to get the quick start off the left wing.
And partner, it helps to have a little luck and unforced turnovers,
yeah,
as we just saw from NC State.
So the ball game is 7 points, 66 to 59. Pittsburgh had 67 points in their loss at Virginia Tech. They lost 81-67 at Blacksburg. Fifteen to shoot for Carr, and there's a moving screen on Chukwuka. 4 now on Kanae. Pittsburgh. But the crowd doesn't like it, but the dribble handoff here. You see Sam Hunt not having an avenue to get through. And Tukuka, if he had come to a jump stop and handed that ball off, I think that's a clean play on.
But the body
fact
moves,
that
right?
He continued to move forward,
yeah,
is what generated that call.
Beverly, 20 to shoot. Your 7 wants a touch here. Brown playing behind him. Beverly launches and hits. Braxton Beverly has 6 on 2 threes.
Beverly is a guy that is willing to take and make big shots. That there pulled the pack within 4. And a chance to set up that pressure half-court defense.
4-point game. We approach 4 minutes to play. Wilson Frame, who had 22 in the first half. Or 22 in the game, 13 in the first half. 9 here in half 2. Brown working on your 7. O'Meara has the 3 fouls. 3 ball misses. Here comes State now. We go inside of 4 minutes to play. The pack to within 4. Markel Johnson. Skip out. Freeman a 3. Got it. Al Freeman's triple. He has 8.5. 11 in the game and a Pittsburgh timeout. Kevin Keats' team back to within 1. We go down the stretch in Pittsburgh after this. Here in Pittsburgh, you see what's at stake. Pittsburgh trying to get their first win in the league. NC State trying to get to 500. The Pack's comeback has been sparked by 3-pointers.
And sharing the basketball, doing an excellent job being unselfish, attacking early, and moving the ball around over shooters against the zone. If you're not going to attack downhill, you must make the zone rotate. And when you catch it, shoot it with confidence. And Braxton Beverly has not shot a hot basketball throughout this contest. But top of the key, steps up, knocks it down. Al Freeman follows suit, knocks down one himself, cutting this lead to 1 point.
State's not changing the plan of attack. Still more pressure in the backcourt. Jared Wilson-Frame. He's got a career-high 22 tonight for the Panthers. With Stevenson, Brown, Carr, and Cameron Davis on the floor for Coach Stallings. Here's Carr working through. Wilson-Frame over Dorn, had it partially blocked. Yurt 7. Picked it up. State can lead for the first time since really early in the game.
West, that's 4 consecutive empty possessions for the Pitt Panthers.
Beverly for the lead. And now we approach 3 minutes to play. Yurt 7 deflected the lead pass for Brown.
West, what we're seeing is a young team trying to figure out how to win close basketball games. The Pitt Panthers have done the job putting themselves in position to defend their home court. Now down the stretch of crunch time, someone has to step up and lead the charge because the Wolfpack, they've been in close games and have had guys step up and make plays. And Tennant Wren right now is a guy, as I said, that's willing to take but also make the big shots.
Braxton Beverly shoots State in front with 2.5 to go. Here's Carr. Davis. 11 to shoot for Pittsburgh. Carr way out with 6 to shoot. Tried to lob it inside, got knocked away. Out of bounds with 2 on the shot clock. 2:15 to play. Tight fit tonight at the Peterson Event Center. Braxton Beverly shot State back to the lead. ACC basketball is brought to you by your local Ford dealer. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of North Carolina. The tools you want, you got it. And by the Works Hydro Shop, the first portable power cleaner. Ready, aim, clean. Well, back here in Pittsburgh, where NC State leads 68-66. 2:15 to play, but 2 seconds to shoot for Pittsburgh after the ball got knocked out of bounds. And Panthers talked about it, so this will have to be pretty quick off the hand of Marcus Carr. In the corner, fired up, Chukwukwa, and it was an air ball. Remember, he's playing with 4 fouls now back on the floor to replace Terrell Brown during the timeout.
You like the decision there from Coach Keats.
He took Markel Johnson off of the inbound and put him right at the center to deter any lob to the hoop, which forced the Pitt Panthers to go outside for a tough contested three-pointer.
They really want to get it to York 7, and they try for the lob on Dorn. Last touch by State. So it will go to Pittsburgh now, under two to play. You see the timeouts are even. And Kevin Keats, who's had a tough start in his ACC coaching career on the road. Losses at Clemson, Notre Dame, and Virginia. Trying to get a very important road win here tonight.
Markel Johnson causing unnecessary frustration there for Coach Keats. Time and score. You can't mess around trying to throw lobs this late in the game.
Kick out for Carr. Three for the lead. Backs out. Johnson the rebound. All the threes that were going in the first half are now rattling out for Pittsburgh here in half two.
UNC State, that's why you just play the percentages. You do the job, continue to defend, and play yourself back into this game, believing that the Pitt Panthers are not going to continue to shoot the ball like they did the first half.
Jason, Pittsburgh led 43-28 with about a minute or so left to go in the first half. State went on that 5-0 run. It was a 10-point game at halftime, 43-33. But as we've gotten deeper into this second half, the pack is trimmed down and finally took the lead on the Beverly three. Kevin Stallings and Kevin Keats are dealing with very different dynamics here, aren't they?
Well, they are. You look at Coach Stallings, a young team who has yet to taste victory in ACC play. They've had a lead, they're trying to hold on, but instead of playing and reacting, now they're thinking and playing slower, leading to empty opportunities on the offensive end. NC State, they have guys that have won big games. You think back to the game Braxton Beverly had, upsetting number two Arizona. He had 20 points. The freshman stepped up, had a big game. This team has knocked off Clemson and knocked off Duke. They've been in tough games when you're talking about NC State. And that experience is paying dividends here late in this contest on the road.
So if you're Pittsburgh, obviously you want to square it defensively. But then when you get the ball back, you're still going to be at a deficit. What are you looking to do? Because the three-point well that was so full in the first half is pretty empty here in half two.
But Jared Wilson-Frame has been the guy to lead the charge offensively. He's on the bench right now for the Panthers. Marcus Carr has to be the guy to make a play. Set a high ball screen, allow him to use his size and strength to get his footprints in the paint. Now it's time to make a basketball play and make a decision, whether for himself or create an opportunity for a teammate.
61 combined threes attempted here tonight in this game. 12 to shoot for State, a minute 15 to play. Dorn trying to go to York 7. 6 to shoot, Johnson. Out front, Beverly, another one. He'll miss everything. It's an air ball. And with a minute 4 to go, Pittsburgh's going to get it back.
But, Wes, that's okay if you're NC State. You took time off the clock. It was an air ball. It goes out of bounds. Now you can set your defense. And NC State's not going to back up off the pressure. The best thing to happen in that possession for the Pack is that time came off the clock now that they hold on to a slim lead.
Minute left to go. Two timeouts for Pittsburgh, one for the Pack. Marcus Carr working against Beverly. Number Wilson Frame, the career high 22, is on the Panther bench. Stevenson, 15 to shoot. Chibuka for the lead. Bounces away. Beverly the rebound. And now all of a sudden, Pittsburgh's only committed 5 fouls here in the second half.
You get a good look, but is that really who you want to take a critical shot late in the game? Nice execution. Got an open shot.
Kevin Keats has got a plan call. He's moved Dorn here to the near corner. Johnson with 8. Freeman attacking. Dorn, catch, shoot, scores. Torin Dorn Jr. with 9.5. 11 in the game.
When you move Torin Dorn out of the middle, it creates more space for a driving line.
Carr the drive, scoring a timeout for Pittsburgh. So now a 2-point game with 10.4 to go. But Jason, I want to come back to Pittsburgh. Has only committed 5 fouls here in the second half.
They're going to have to foul quick and in a hurry. 10 ticks to go left in this contest. Wes, I think you're going to see a quick trap to see if the Panthers can get a deflection and a steal here in front of their basket. After that, they're going to have to continue to foul and force the Wolfpack to inbound the pass correctly, the receivers to receive the basketball and be strong with it, and then march to the line and try to finish this game at the foul.
Nearly a 6-minute drought for Pittsburgh. Is ended by the Marcus Carr bucket a moment ago, but here's the last play for State.
Al Freeman attacking the paint, and Torn Dorn, we've seen this before, him making a big shot. Just Johnny on the spot, moving without the basketball, knocks down that timely jumper there, and Dorn was the guy that put the Blue Devils away with that 4-point play, like that contest. He seems to do all the little things you see on the verge of a double-double. None bigger than that two there in traffic.
All right, so Dorn's going to put it in play. Elagoma has come on the floor, and he will defend the inbound pass. State can't run the baseline here after the made basket. And Dorn will try to get it inbounds. It does to Beverly, and there's the foul by Carr. And a second comes off the clock. That's number 6 on Pittsburgh.
Tough pass there. No, Coach Keats holding his breath on the sideline. Torn Dorn, you can run the baseline. You don't want to throw a bounce pass that far away. You look at Carr, very close to getting his hand on that basketball.
And there's the foul by Stewart on Freeman. And another second comes off the clock. Second on Stewart. That's 7 now on Pittsburgh. So with 8.5 to play, Al Freeman to the line. He is 3 for 3 tonight. And Jared Wilson-Frame hustles back on the floor for Pittsburgh. Along with Kanae Chukwuka.
And that last break of action, Coach Stallings drew up what he wanted his team to do offensively as well. They talked about trapping, trying to force a tough inbounds pass, but also what he wanted to do on the offensive end as well. Now he calls a timeout, wanting to refresh his team's minds, understanding this is a young ball club, first time in this situation, ACC play, coming down to the last few possessions.
Pittsburgh is out of timeouts. NC State will have a 30 left. Pittsburgh is empty in the timeout category. Possession arrow points toward the Panthers, by the way, with 8.5 to go. Another conversion of a free throw by Freeman here, Jason, and it becomes a 2-possession game, though.
Coach Stallings, one of the great offensive minds in college basketball. Wes, right now, with 8 seconds to go, you have to get down the court as quick as possible and get the best look you can possibly get. A quick layup is ideal. Set up your defense, and once again, force the Wolfpack to finish this game at the foul.
Is NC State going to press this after the Freeman free throw if they make it?
Absolutely. They're not going to allow Pitt to catch that ball on the run and simply drive the ball down the court. But what you have to do is have great discipline if you're NC State. Show your hands, move your feet. Simply be there to block the ball handler, not to make contact and ensure you don't foul him, but make it tougher for him to get down the court and hopefully run time off the clock.
State's got 2 fouls to give. So think of that as well. Actually, 3 fouls to give. They've only committed 4 of them. So that's pretty interesting, too. Freeman, though, this is the critical free throw. Changes the possession count. Any coach will tell you inside 10, 15 seconds, a possession count is more valuable than just about anything else, Jason.
Absolutely. And though NC State has 2 fouls to give, you do not want to stop the clock. You want to let that clock continue to run. Defend without fouling.
Here's Carr. He'll spot, fire, that's a 3. Back rim miss, slapped up in the air, Yurt 7 the rebound. And the horn sounds, and NC State comes all the way back tonight to beat the Pittsburgh Panthers. Disappointing loss for Kevin Stallings and his team, Jason. But what an effort by Kevin Keats' club, huh?
Coach Keats' team fought, toughed out a road win, stuck to their game plan, and found a way to win and partner ACC play. That's what it's all about, finding ways to win, especially on the road.
72-68, the Pack a winner for Jason Capel. Wes Durham, thanks for watching ACC College Hoops.